Imagine a world where giant solar power stations orbit the Earth, harvesting sunlight to power millions of homes, or vast projects designed to absorb carbon from the air and restore balance to our fragile climate. Humanity is turning to massive, groundbreaking solutions as global temperatures rise and weather patterns shift. These climate megaprojects might be the last hope for reversing the damage done. From space-based solar power to cutting-edge carbon capture technologies, these initiatives could dramatically reshape our energy landscape and help achieve net zero emissions by 2050. Will these engineering marvels be enough to save the planet, or are we running out of time? Space-based solar power station. As the world searches for new energy sources to address climate change, space-based solar power has emerged as a groundbreaking solution that could revolutionize how we generate electricity. Instead of relying on earthbound renewable systems, often hindered by weather and day-night cycles, solar power stations in space promise a continuous, uninterrupted flow of clean energy. Positioned high above our planet, these vast solar arrays collect sunlight around the clock, transmitting that energy wirelessly to Earth. The potential to harness such abundant energy from space is no longer science fiction, but a fast-evolving reality. The construction of these solar power stations involves assembling massive, lightweight solar panels in space. A feat that requires the launch of thousands of components into orbit, it's not without its challenges. Once in place, these panels collect solar radiation and convert it into electricity, which is then beamed down to Earth using high-frequency electromagnetic waves. On the ground, antennas called rectennas receive the transmitted energy and convert it into electricity for use in the grid. The sheer scale of these projects is staggering, with some designs envisioning stations as large as several kilometers in diameter. Despite the technical hurdles, the advantages of space-based solar power are immense. These stations would generate energy 24/7, unaffected by weather or Earth's atmosphere, making them up to 13 times more efficient than terrestrial solar farms. This constant power supply could dramatically reduce the need for expensive and large-scale energy storage systems, ensuring a reliable energy flow to meet rising global demands. With ambitious plans to operate space-based solar power within the next few decades, this technology could play a crucial role in achieving global sustainability targets. Denmark's energy islands. As the winds of change blow stronger across the globe, a revolutionary idea is taking shape far off the Danish coast, where vast stretches of open sea will soon host one of the world's most ambitious energy projects. Denmark's energy islands are setting the stage for a future powered by wind, with these artificial hubs transforming offshore wind energy into a key driver of Europe's green revolution. Anchored deep in the North Sea, one of these islands will gather and distribute energy from surrounding wind farms, harnessing the power of immense turbines designed to capture more wind than ever before. In its first phase, this innovative island will generate up to 4 gigawatts of electricity, enough to power millions of households. As it expands, its output will eventually rise to a remarkable 10 gigawatts, becoming a critical source of clean energy for Denmark and beyond. On the Baltic Sea's Bornholm Island, a similar transformation is underway. Bornholm will serve as a gateway for wind energy, channeling 3 gigawatts of power to the grids of Denmark and neighboring countries, supporting the phasing out of fossil fuels in Europe. Together, these energy islands represent a game-changing effort to push renewable energy to new limits. But building these energy behemoths is no small task. The construction process presents significant logistical challenges, from overcoming harsh offshore conditions to ensuring that the island's presence minimally impacts the marine ecosystem. Protecting Thwaites Glacier. As we turn from the windswept seas to the icy frontier, the next megaproject tackles an even more formidable force. Antarctica's Thwaites Glacier, ominously known as the Doomsday Glacier. This massive ice shelf is melting at an alarming rate, contributing around 4% of global sea level rise each year. If left unchecked, its collapse could raise sea levels by up to 3 meters, triggering catastrophic flooding in coastal cities worldwide. The Thwaites Glacier sits like a keystone in the West Antarctic ice sheet, and its destabilization could set off a devastating chain reaction, pulling surrounding ice into the ocean and intensifying the global sea level crisis. To address this looming threat, geoengineers have proposed an ambitious solution to safeguard the glacier. The project involves the construction of immense underwater curtains, extending for over 96 kilometers along the seabed. These seabed-anchored curtains, made from specially designed geotextile material, are designed to block warm ocean currents from reaching the glacier's vulnerable underside. The warm currents, which have been accelerating the glacier's melt from below, are a primary driver of its rapid retreat. By preventing this warm water from undermining the glacier, the ice sheet could restabilize, potentially thickening and halting its relentless march towards the sea. The curtains are designed to work by creating a physical barrier that redirects the warm water away from the glacier. This could allow the Thwaites Glacier to regain some of its former stability and buy humanity precious time. If successful, the project could potentially preserve the glacier for centuries, delaying its collapse and reducing the immediate threat of sea level rise, while also contributing to long-term climate stabilization efforts on a global scale. Regreen the Sinai Peninsula. Our next stop takes us to the vast desert of the Sinai Peninsula, where an audacious vision is taking root. Once a flourishing oasis, this arid region now stretches as a harsh, barren landscape. But a new project aims to restore it to its former glory by regreening the desert and reviving its natural water cycles. Covering approximately 35,000 square kilometers, the mission is to turn back the clock and breathe new life into the Sinai, sparking an ecological transformation that could reshape the region and even influence global weather patterns. At the heart of this grand project lies the goal of restoring the water cycle. The plan is to dredge sediments from Lake Bardawil, a critical water body in northern Sinai, and use these nutrient-rich materials to regenerate the surrounding desert. By treating the lake and improving its water quality, the project hopes to revitalize marine life and increase local fish populations. But this is only the beginning. These restored wetlands will set the stage for a much larger transformation, where vegetation will begin to take hold, kicking off a chain reaction that could draw moisture back into the atmosphere and ultimately lead to increased rainfall. The idea is simple but powerful. By reintroducing plant life into the desert, the project aims to restore the balance of nature, encouraging more evaporation, cloud formation, and rain. The ancient rivers that once flowed through the Sinai could flow again as the region's natural hydrological systems are reactivated. This massive ecological regeneration could help reverse desertification, improve food and water security for local communities, and create a more sustainable future. This initiative is no small feat and may take decades to fully realize its vision, but the rewards are monumental. If successful, the Sinai could once again be a thriving, fertile land, and this restoration effort could serve as a blueprint for tackling climate change on a global scale. Pulling carbon dioxide straight from the air. As the fight against climate change intensifies, innovative technologies are emerging with the goal of directly removing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. One of the most promising solutions is direct air capture, or DAC, which involves machines designed to pull CO2 from the air. While still in its infancy, this technology is rapidly advancing and holds the potential to significantly reduce greenhouse gas concentrations. The challenge is immense, as humans release billions of tons of CO2 annually. But the capability of DAC plants is growing exponentially, with some facilities already capturing tens of thousands of tons each year. The process typically involves large industrial fans pulling air into the machines, where the CO2 is absorbed onto a solid material or dissolved into liquid. Once captured, the gas is separated and prepared for long-term storage. One method involves dissolving the CO2 in water and injecting it deep underground, where it reacts with minerals in the rock to form solid carbonates, locking the carbon away for millennia. Another approach uses existing oil reserves to sequester the CO2, effectively reversing the process that initially extracted fossil fuels. Despite its promise, the scalability and cost of DAC technology remain challenges. Current operations are costly, with prices per ton of CO2 removed still high. However, experts believe that as the technology matures and scales, costs will fall dramatically, potentially reaching levels that make DAC a significant part of global efforts to reduce atmospheric carbon. The race is on to scale this technology rapidly, ensuring it can play a pivotal role in achieving the world's ambitious climate goals. If you enjoyed this journey, please like, comment, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more exciting content ahead.